I'm sure you all have talked over the weekend, though. This is pretty exciting. 8,500 potential seats.
Yes.
Your reaction just from what you've heard?
You know, I'm extremely excited. I think that in order for us to attack poverty in our city, we must definitely get aggressive about funding universal pre-K. Mm-hmm. I think this is an opportunity that the city is stepping up, providing $6 million to help fund this.
Right.
And the way that the administration has come up with the actual funding mechanism is definitely creative and does not cost our taxpayers any additional revenue. And we don't have to discuss this year during budget to raise taxes. And, you know, thank my colleagues for allowing me an opportunity to co-sponsor this, Kemp, and our good friend Patrice Robinson. We really championed this idea and the thought to get aggressive on ways to mitigate and reduce poverty in our city.
And Kemp, we know you've been kind of leading the way on this for a long time, talks about pre-K and the city of Memphis getting back in the business of trying to help especially our young people. Why so now? Why do this?
You know, sometimes it's just kind of all about timing. And, you know, Memphis budget, it's almost a $700 million budget now. And I think a lot of people think, well, $6 million, that's not a whole lot. But really, that $6 million, our goal is to leverage it up really to become $40 million. So the pre-K piece of our holistic early childhood strategy in this community is about $16 million. But there's a lot that needs to happen for folks before pre-K. You know, if you look at what we did around infant mortality several years ago, we had a very high infant mortality rate. We've driven it down with a community-wide effort. Well, those babies are healthier. They're going to be healthier as little children. And then when they get into pre-K, and then it's also what happens from pre-K getting into kindergarten and the third grade.
Being kindergarten ready.
That's right. So there's an organization called Seeding for Success that has now got all the stakeholders together that are really focused on child and family well-being. And so there's another big part of this. There's going to be some private funding announced. So, but the city had to be at the table. I don't think any of this would happen if the city wasn't at the table. So that $6 million is going to leverage the county piece, hopefully the school board doing more to become the 16 for universal needs-based pre-K. But then there's another additional that'll go up to that $40 million for this continuum around children.
And we're not just talking about replacing the seats that the federal grant pays
and
for now. It's about 1,500 more, right?
More,
so it's pretty significant.
That's
Explain
exactly right.
How it will be funded. It messes with the pilots, which a lot of people
it really doesn't mess,
say they don't
it really
like.
Doesn't mess with it at all.
No, it uses it.
Yeah,
though.
It's very simple. We're going to take one penny from our tax rate and dedicate it. That's what's so important about being brilliant at the basics. When you run city government more effectively and more efficiently, it frees up dollars to then invest in things like this. I'll give you an example.
For long-term
our results. Metro alarms, we've like quadrupled or doubled the number of alarm revenue from our Metro Alarm Office, making that run more effectively. And then to answer your question, the large piece of it though, when tax breaks, the pilots expire, instead of that money going to the general fund, we're going to take a portion of it.
Because we haven't had it, so it's like...
Well, no, they do roll off, but typically they go to the general fund.
Right.
As they roll off...
In other words, we won't miss it. The general fund won't miss
That's right. And then hopefully the county is going to do the same thing. I think a lot of the county commissioners are on board with this. Mayor Luttrell has said that he supports it. So with the county piece and the city piece, that gives about 12 of the $16 million. And then we help the school board to fill in the gap, and that's the $16 million we need.
All right, let's talk about a few other issues here, also involving de-annexation this year. Where do we stand on that? Also, we're hearing more about a study about Kroger stores or maybe to bring some type of grocery stores back to an area south Memphis that's really needed there. Where do we stand on those issues?
You know, de-annexation is still an issue that the council is dealing with, the administration is dealing with, because we didn't know exactly what was going to come out of the state as far as forcing us to de-annex certain areas of Memphis. The council and the administration agrees there are certain areas that's costing the city money, that's not really producing an adequate amount of revenue. We have an area that we are exploring. Two areas where there's no residents, one area where there's about 12 to 15 residents. So we're definitely planning to de-annex those areas. And hopefully we move forward with making the Memphis the right size. And it's just about right sizing our city to increase revenue and provide better service.
And what about the study about bringing Kroger stores or some type of store to this area that's pretty much been abandoned?
You know, Councilman Ford and Council Swearingen, they're taking the lead on trying to get a study done. This group that they hired will do a market analysis and look at the overall amount of people that's on different assistance. Look at transportation needs for the services that's being provided, as far as banking, as far as having a pharmacy, and to determine if there's an actual end user to take those two Kroger stores.
And the money is well spent, you think, for the study? Because a lot of times people hear study and they go, really?
Absolutely. I think the study is less than $20,000. Again, right. A $700 million budget. And I think a great example of this is what we did several years ago with the Easy, or the, I forget the name of the grocery store, but in Binghamton. Yeah. It didn't just happen.
Sure.
We had to put, but
right.
Now there's a store there for those residents. So
right.
We need to be thoughtful about it. I think it's a fantastic investment.
One last thing as we approach MLK 50, any other major developments we need to know about as the city gears up for this?
Well, I just think that the city has shown a lot of support thus far. We're having a great turnout, great responses. I think people, the whole country, will have their eye on Memphis. And just appreciating the sacrifices that those sanitation workers, as well as Dr. King, made to make the city, make this world a better place.